My name is Panos Xenokostas. I'm the founder and CEO of Onyx Technologies Group, and today I'm going to present to you my new venture, the Neorio Shipyard in Cirrus Island. Since Mr. Buffett believes that in order to become rich you have to close the doors and to be fearful when others greedy, and the opposite in order to become rich, I could not describe better than him why investing in Greece and in turnaround cases is a smart decision that will pay off during the next 5 to 15 years. Okay. Thank you. Let's have a closer now look at Eastern Mediterranean. Let's focus on Greece, a country which is placed on the crossroad of Asia and Europe. Greece is Europe's and Western civilization eastern border. We can easily realize why Greeks developed maritime, since they are living in the most mountain terrain. All these factors exalted in a way ancient Greeks to develop maritime, and most of all to construct extremely sophisticated, for the times, vessels, such as the famous trireme. Maritime became for the Greeks the core of their commerce. Through expeditions, managed to establish their colonies outside the borders of motherland Greece to the outskirts of Eastern Mediterranean. In the times when Europe was threatened by the so-called barbaric armies, the mighty Athenian navy saved democracy and the Western civilization. Maritime and shipbuilding never stopped playing an important role for the Greek nation. Almost every island and port of continental Greece had a small shipyard. During the Ottoman Empire, after the Greek independence, and especially after the World War II, the Greek mercantile marine flourished and still keeps afloat in rough seas. For the emerging needs for the new larger ships, bigger and more sophisticated facilities were established in Elefsina, Chalkida, and Syros. Therefore, shipping was one of the major factors that in 2015 placed Greece in the top as the first ship-owned country in the world, a true Greek shipping miracle. Besides this tremendous development, in maritime, the shipbuilding and ship repairing sector is in a constant decline, which started from the decades of 70s and 80s. The adoption of the nationalization model for the Greek economy, and especially in the industrial sector, which started approximately in 1974, resulted to the creation of an enormous public sector and to tremendous changes in labor mentality. Severe taxation was imposed in business operations and investments in Greece. The labor costs rose, and manipulated unionism became almost an authority. Along with outdated labor legislation, even the most modest investment in the country became a fit. Investors with major projects in shipbuilding and ship repairing that were destined to the Greek business environment were forced to flee, and were accepted unconditionally in neighboring countries such as Turkey, Romania, and Croatia, nations with almost non-existing tradition in maritime. Nowadays, Turkey has approximately 160 shipyards in full operations, from only one in the 90s. And Croatia in 2008 was the second shipbuilding country in Europe. So, is there any future for the Greek shipyards? Straight answer, absolutely yes. Actually, we build it right now. Onyx Shipyards is a member and special purpose vehicle of Onyx Technologies, with a strategic goal of purchasing, operating, and investment in Neorio Shipyards. As a shipbuilding, repairing, and upgrading organization, we will revitalize one of the oldest and historical shipyards in Greece, the Neorio in the island of Syros. It will be ready to offer the customers integrated solutions tailored to their needs, while by the same time providing a complete package of services. Neorin is one of the oldest Greek heavy industries located in Hermopolis, on the Greek island of Syros. Today, it is one of the few remaining major industrial corporations in shipbuilding in what used to be the industrial and commercial center of Greece before being eclipsed by Piraeus in the late 19th century. For the Greek industrial sector, Neorion has always been a pioneering facility. Neorion was the first steam iron works industry in the Eastern Mediterranean. It was producing steam engines, boilers, even war materials. The breakthrough for Neorion was the development worldwide of the first electric car in the 70s. Today, the installations and facilities are adequate, but they have to get modernized and converted to the new activities of Onyx shipyards. Neorion also is equipped by a synchro lift of 2.5 thousand tons, which is the biggest in the region, and this capacity is to serve vessels up to 100 meters long, installed especially for the mega yacht market. The Neorion Syros shipyard will be modernized for new activities, along with its current works, such as repairing, manufacturing, and yacht building in order to meet the challenges of the new era. We transform Neorion to a modern yard that will continue to perform all the current repair and manufacturing procedures more efficiently for the commercial vessels, and we will provide a full portfolio of services as you see on the slide. The market is huge, and please have in mind, bear in mind that 60% of the market that you see on the slide, 1.8 billion, is controlled directly or indirectly by Greek ship owners. In Neorion have been already built two mega yachts of 88 meters each. Onyx shipyards, though, goes beyond that. Besides manufacturing and repairing, our goal is to provide support and a complete package of services that do not only keep the boats in the best possible condition, but pave the way to a new future with innovations and improvements in the industry. In our one-stop shop, clients from around the world can find a portfolio of added value services. Onyx shipyards, through existing partnerships with other leading groups in shipbuilding, designing, energy and technology, will introduce new activities that will allow Neorion to penetrate new market segments and utilize its strategic location and more than 130 years of manufacturing legacy. We provide in Neorion the most modern infrastructure for constructing and repairing all NATO naval platforms. All the needs and requirements of the NATO fleet operating in the Eastern Mediterranean will be fulfilled. The shipyard will accommodate corvettes, fast attack crafts, frigates, destroyers, mine hunters, and submarines. Aluminium. The teaming partnership agreement is by itself a milestone in the history of ferry market worldwide. We're going to focus in building fast aluminium ferries from 20 to 120 meters long. Our goal is to simply change the market to a new, faster, more efficient and higher intense passenger solutions and ferries. As there is an ever-increasing need for exploitation of natural resources, the market for ocean and coastal fixed mining platforms and general offshore equipment shows a steady and upward trend. In this context, Onyx shipyards, recognizing the enormous opportunities that Greek shipyards can make in the field of repairs, upgrades, and construction of these particular constructions, already creates the infrastructure for the specific works so that they can be carried out on the Greek territory. Our clients will enjoy the best value for money advanced services in the region. LNG usage as the new fuel of commercial vessels that will come into force by the International Maritime Organization in the forthcoming future is imposed by the implementation of stringent emission limits and the increased environmental awareness for the clean transportation. For the Greek territory, it will be a great importance, the conversion of the propulsion plants of the existing open ferries, which are used for short distance route close to the urban areas from the diesel fuel mode to the LNG fuel mode. Our route will not be without challenges, challenges we already know the way to address. In general, shipyards in Western Europe face harsh competition from the Eastern Europe countries due to one key factor, extremely low labor cost. Western companies have to bring back their lost clientele. Is it possible? Absolutely yes. Let's see how Finland managed to attract new shipbuilding and ship repairing projects. Business optimization, time efficiency, green and new technologies, innovation, diversification, and above all, flexibility. So, what we can learn from the case of Finland is that in order to change the climate in favor of the Western shipyards, we have to emphasize added value service, improve efficiency in cost and delivery, enhance new technologies, and as in the case of Greece, consider strategic and geopolitical aspects. There are many who question the ability of Greece to support major investments in its soil. These doubts are generated by the events of the past few years and the devaluation of Greek economy. But do these arguments are really solid? Greece, as once the most developed economy and society in the region, has already passed the phase of claims for utopian social changes. And now it's turned to a new perspective. And this crisis comes to an end because everybody understands that it's not about actually dealing with the end of the crisis. It's actually about dealing and realizing and accepting the new reality and build everything from scratch point for a better future. As Heraclitus quoted, history operates in cycles. At the peak of Greek financial development, social claims for excessive salaries was a determinant factor for investors. International investors in shipbuilding will prefer Greek craftsmen who are highly specialized and offer high level of labor production. The wages and the labor's legislation offers a more industrial friendly environment comparable to regional alternatives, and we are in a phase that the reindustrialization of Greece in specific sectors is not a funny story or a pre-elections political speech, but an achievable target. Let's have a look now at three major regional competitors of Greece in ship repairing: Croatia, Romania, and Turkey. Croatia and Romania were for many years parts of the former Eastern Bloc. They started attracting investments due to the extremely low labor cost, but with a questionable quality of work. The current trend depicts compliance to European standards and directives, but also a significant raise of wages at level. Turkey, on the other hand, was always a magnet for investors due to the stable political status and state derivation. Wages were extremely low. Industrial development, though, was followed by salaries increases, and now Turkey's labor cost tends to become a deterrent factor for the investors. Political stability is also questioned. Now, I know that some of you, maybe most of you or all of you, may think that you're watching a crazy or romantic guy talking about visions and dreams, bringing back ship repairing and ship building in Greece. I just have to remind everybody what Steve Jobs said. My goal is very simple. I want to change the ship repairing sector in Eastern Mediterranean and bring new business innovations and technologies in the sector. Greeks are the most powerful entrepreneurs in shipping. As a Greek-American company, my goal is to join them by bringing with me the Greek shipyards at that level. As a US company, my goal is to utilize strategic assets to rewrite the history in the sector, to rewrite business stories in one of the oldest and most valuable strategic partners of the United States, Greece. By implanting the American business DNA to the Greek assets, by implanting the American dream in Greece's most valuable asset, the Greek hardworking human capital. This way you can establish a bridge between US investors and US know-how with the Greek economy, via danceable, solid, innovative, and above all, profitable investments, like Israel did it. We have the means and we have the methods. We have the vision, we know how, and we will get it done. Thank you all.